behind him. The United States national champion from Great Falls, Montana, Scott Davis.
And this is pressure. Element is also triple axel combination, triple axel to double toe loop. Tilted way outside, had to do a turn in between the two jumps. Minor duction. Scott Davis is the best spinner in the entire men's event. Just watch every spin he does. They're absolutely incredible. He can't make any more mistakes. This next jump is very difficult. Triple lutz. Quality of his spins, position here.
Wasn't perfect, but pretty good. Scott Davis. We'll be back with his marks right after this message.
Another look at the triple axel. You're going to see why this jump is so difficult, especially when you tilt it outside the circle, meaning tilting it left. If you stop it right there, he is tilted this way. He's landing on his right foot. It's very difficult to save this jump when you're tilted to the outside or to the left when you're landing right. He did a great job hanging on and salvaging as much as he could out of that combination. Another look at the triple lutz. I couldn't tell from where I was if his hand touched. If his hand did touch down, it's another 2/10 deduction. We can see everybody's trained to go, no, he might have been an inch off the ice, but the judges might have thought that he touched the ground. If he did, a 2/10 deduction.
Now the first set of marks for Scott Davis.
And you can really see the value of a triple axel in combination. These marks are as good or better than Eric Nillot, who skated clean. Scott had a couple problems, but minor deductions. 5, 5, 5, 4, 5.
That's his coach, Kathy Casey, sitting to his left. And they wait for the second set of marks.
And these are great. The judges are conservative. Elvis Stoiko's program met with a little resistance. Scott Davis's program is much easier for them to mark.
By the slimmest of margins, Scott Davis slips into second place, trailing Elvis Stoiko. The real shock is down there in the fifth spot, Brian Boitano, and in sixth position right now, the defending gold medalist, Victor Petrenko. And Scott, the shock came very early this evening.
It's incredible. Brian Boitano has not missed all week long, and to miss in the technical program in competition, it's taken him out of all chance at a medal, I think, because we have a great list of skaters coming up in this last group. Alexei Ermanov, the third place finisher at last year's World Championships. Philippe Candeloro, if he can hold it together, he's a great entertainer. He could sneak in there. And world champion Kurt Browning skates last. If he can hold it together, he can win this technical program and set himself up for a gold medal.
Elvis Stoiko leads at the moment, and he's downstairs with Tracy Wilson.
Elvis, you look totally relaxed and confident out there. Did it take the pressure off knowing that Victor and Brian had both made mistakes?
Well, I think you can take it either way. If they had skated well, then we'd put the pressure on, but I'd be even more focused on my thing, saying, I can't miss, I got to stay in the hunt and go on from there. I knew that a couple of the guys had skated well, like Steven and Eric Milo, and a lot of guys that are good are coming up after me as well. So I knew that I had to just go in for a good skate. No matter what happens with the other competitors, my main goal is to skate for myself and enjoy it.
Great job, Elvis.
Thanks.